What's good, you YouTube? It's your boy Quinn Wade, basketball analysis. Free agency start Saturday at 12, so it'll basically be Sunday. You know it's gonna be busy. I gotta cover the whole NBA trades and free agent signing, so it's gonna be fun this week. We're gonna talk about Ricky Rubio just got traded to the Utah Jazz. Obviously, I'm not the biggest fan of Ricky Rubio, but at the same time, he's a respectable defensive point guard. He's on a decent contract, even though it's almost up. So at worst, honestly, this would be you picking up Ricky Rubio just to try him out, test him, and if it fails, you just let him go somewhere else, and you just get the cap space. But you still got George Hill. I believe that he a free agent this year. If you don't want to overpay for George Hill because he was injured majority of the season, even though when he was healthy, it was hard to beat. He was injured in the playoffs too. The dude just couldn't stay healthy. But one thing I like about George Hill before, if he leaves, is that he was more aggressive. George Hill was real subtle. He wasn't really in attack mode. And when he went to Utah, he was attacking, finding his shot, confident in his shot. At one point, he was averaging 20 points a game. The dude found how they finally found the way to use George Hill the right way, because the dude just didn't really do anything in San Antonio and in Indiana, and he finally found his niche in Utah. So if he doesn't stay, you pick up Ricky Rubio for a first round pick. If Ricky Rubio don't work out, you get the salary cap because his contract is almost up. So either way, you give up a first round pick for probably 10, 11, 12 million off the salary cap. So it's not really that big of a trade. And if Ricky Rubio do work out, he's not a max player. He's a decent point guard. He still can't shoot, even though he improved a little bit last year. He can run a team. He is patient. He's a decent defender. And he just give you somebody to rent. Or he gives you somebody that has potential to be a starter for you next couple years. They still have Exum. They still have some decent players on this roster. Ain't like they need Ricky Rubio, but at the same time, they need somebody to start just in case they lose George Hill or they gotta overpay for George Hill. Let him go and just start Ricky Rubio instead. If Ricky Rubio don't work out either, you get the cap space to sign somebody else that can fill the spot, or you can just give it to Dante Exum when he's ready because his rookie deal is almost up. So either way, this is a low risk, high reward trade, and even if it was bust, even though Ricky Rubio become a bust, you still get cap space in the future because he got a big contract or extension already. So we'll see what happens. I think this is a trade that really ain't gonna make that big of a difference. It's not really bad. It's not really good. It's just them trying to secure their point guard position for next season and probably a season after that. But like I said, they do have Dante Exum and other players to play backup point in a point guard position. So let me know what you guys think. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. Like my website, AnalysisPlayground.com. There's a Facebook link in the description below. Also, go to my website, AnalysisPlayground.com. It's in the description and in the comment section below. It's a link. Click that. You can go right to the website. Click that. You can go right to the Facebook page. Thanks for watching. Comment, like, subscribe, and share. And let me know what you guys think about the Ricky Rubio trade and what he can do for the Utah Jazz.